Hello, welcome to Waldock Crafts. Today we're talking about our audio and visual system in our Galaxy and Limo units. So there's a few things. Right now we're equipping our vans with the Jensen JWM90A model audio unit here. In order to power this on, you will need to have the vehicle running or key on. There are four auxiliary switches here. All video function is powered on by auxiliary 3. That would include your television. And all audio is powered through our auxiliary 4 switch here. So you'll need to have key on. Those two switches flip to run all audio function. The next thing you'll want to power on is for audio and visual both. You'll want your Jensen unit turned on. For video, you will want to drop down the 32-inch Jensen television. You can do that with this switch in the wall. A couple notes about the system is that this Jensen unit is a zone-controlled audio system. There are three audio zones, Zone A, Zone B, and Zone C. An audio source can be selected per zone, and volume can be individually controlled by zone. Zone A is the lead zone and can affect the input of Zone B and C. The simplest way to ensure each zone is playing the audio source you want is to select source on the Jensen unit for each of the three zones, A, B, and C, starting with Zone A, and we'll get into that in a moment here. Each accessory in our vans is linked to the system in the following manner. Bluetooth audio is linked through the Jensen Media Center. The Bluetooth button is here. The RCA Game Ready switch found in our wall here is linked to the RC component inputs on the television up here inside the television case. And the HDMI switcher is located inside our wall here. There's an access panel right here. And that HDMI switcher runs the HDMI signal from various sources to the television. When that is set to HDMI 1 using this remote here, you'll be linked to the Jensen DVD player. When this is set to HDMI 2, it'll be linked to the Apple TV if the van is equipped with an Apple TV. And HDMI 3, the third button on the remote here, is the HDMI port next to the blind and TV control located here. So we'll start with DVD function. For DVD function, again, you'll need key on, and you'll need switches 3 and 4 turned on. Next, you'll want to ensure that the power to your television is turned on, your television remote, located here, and you can also turn it on with the power button on your television remote. After that, you'll want to ensure that the Jensen unit is powered on. And you can do that with this button here or with the Jensen remote. So after your Jensen is powered up, you can load your DVD. The system should sense that a DVD is in there and make audio adjustments to your source input, and your DVD should begin to play after it loads. If for any reason you're not getting an audio signal, you'll just want to make sure that the zone settings on your Jensen unit are programmed correctly. And in this case for DVD, you'll want your zone settings set to disc for DVD. And all zones are currently set to disc. And that is our DVD function. Obviously, you can play your DVD using the remote here. All right, so the second visual feature, audio feature, some bands are equipped with is Apple TV, located here on the wall. Again, you'll want to make sure that the vehicle key is either in the running position or in the on accessory position. Your toggles for auxiliary switches 3 and 4 on the dash will need to be on. And for Apple TV, you'll want to switch your HDMI switcher located in the wall panel here using this remote to input 2. The eye for this remote and the HDMI switcher are located above the television here. So this remote has to have a clean line of sight to the infrared eye here. So here we've pulled up our Apple TV screensaver. You'll need to log in with your account. There's an Apple TV remote. Here. Also, we'll need to change our Jensen settings on our zones. So you press the zone button here. We'll need to skip to rear auxiliary. For all zones A, B, and C. To select zones, hit the zone button. Here we have zone C, switch to rear auxiliary. You hit zone again, and we'll go to zone A. We're gonna switch that function using this knob until the screen says rear auxiliary. To enter, hit, just push in on the button there. So now all three zones are set to rear auxiliary, and we can go back to select our media on our Apple TV. You can start by pressing the menu button. This pulls up our Apple TV menu. You can scroll over, select movies or television, whichever you're going to watch. In this case, we will play I'm going to try and get an example video up here. And you can select with the remote. This is your enter button here, the wide flat screen, as well as your directional arrows. Press it to select an item. This pulls up the film if you want to purchase it or if you already own it. I'm going to select preview. For volume control, you'll have to turn to our Jensen unit again, either using the remote or the head unit itself. You can go to zones, hit your zone button. We have zone A, and I can turn up the volume. Using that dial. So now I'm turning up zone B, hit the zone button again to go to zone C, hit the zone button one more time to get the volume stage, and I can turn up zone C as well.
whatever you're looking for.
Same function for turning down the volume in each zone. Each zone powers a different part of the van. Zone A powers the front speakers here in the rear of the van, as well as the subwoofer located in the rear of the van. Zone B is our middle speakers here and here. And Zone C are our rear speakers located in the upper rear shroud. So that's the general operation of the Apple TV. To use our HDMI wall port located next to here, located next to the game ready switch and directly adjacent to the power shade or power TV switch. To use this wall port for a separate DVD player or a gaming unit, again, you'll make sure that the key is in the on or in the accessory on position. Our auxiliary switch is 3 and 4. Our switch to the on position as well. That your Jensen unit is powered up and that your TV is in the down position and turned on. After that, the steps are essentially the same. You'll want your HDMI, or you'll want the TV set to HDMI 1 to use the wall port here. Note, if there is no Apple TV, the switcher will need to be set to HDMI 2 in your wall. HDMI switcher located here. Using this small remote, you would then set it to 2. If you are equipped with Apple TV, you'll want your HDMI switcher set to HDMI 3. Again, the Jensen player, Zone A, will have to be set to rear auxiliary as a source. Jensen Zone B will need to be set to rear auxiliary for its source. And the Jensen Meteor player, Zone C, will need to be set to rear auxiliary as its source. After the media player zones inputs have been selected, the volume for each zone can be controlled separately by cycling through your zones. Again, that button is here. Here I have Zone C selected. If I press the button again, I can then control that volume for that individual zone by its own. If I need to select a different zone, hit the zone button twice, 3 times, and you get selection to Zone A. Hit it one more time, and you can select your input as rear auxiliary. Hit it a third time, and you can control your volume for that zone. If you want to use the RCA Game Ready ports for your game system, it is located here, just behind the driver's seat on the driver rear wall. Here are your RC ports, video, left and right audio. These are wired directly to the television. The vehicle will need to be in the on position. Your dash auxiliaries 3 and 4 will need to be switched on, and your TV will need to be set to component. You can control that here under source. So the Jensen audio unit is also capable of Bluetooth pairing. To enter Bluetooth pairing mode, make sure that your key is set to accessory or the vehicle is running. Again, your auxiliary switches 3 and 4 will need to be switched to the on position. Make sure your Jensen unit is on. And to pair for Bluetooth, simply press the BT button and hold it until the screen here indicates that it is in pairing mode. You'll then go through the steps on your phone or tablet or other Bluetooth device to pair with our Jensen unit. Once paired, you can play your media through this. As an example, I will go to my Pandora music station and you can then play your media through the Jensen audio system. Volume control with the system, again, is controlled through the zones. Simply press the zone button twice and it will move to zone A and your volume control. You can change your volume for zone A that way. If you hit the zone button and cycle through to zone B, hit it twice and you can control your volume for zone B. Hit the zone button again until you cycle to zone C. Hit it one more time and then you can control your zone C volume. And that is an overview of Bluetooth connection and Bluetooth use on the Jensen audio system. So a new feature with the JWM90A is the ability to download an app via the Android App Store or your Apple App Store. You can use your telephone, your smartphone, as a remote. In this case, this is an Android app, but you can go to your app store and pull. What you'll search for is J Control. You'll pull up that app, install the app, and once it downloads, you can open the app, and it will pull up a interface screen, the Jensen interface screen. I currently have my Pandora linked to our Jensen unit. I can control volume using my phone's volume button. This allows me to skip tracks as well through Pandora. It's a very convenient feature that I think most people with smartphones will find quite interesting and convenient to use.